Hello and welcome to another one of my very occasional technical videos, and this one shows you how to outline individual figures within images. And this is a technique often used on YouTube thumbnails, where it helps to liven up pictures and try to make them more eye-catching. So in this video I'll be showing you how to outline figures using Pixelmator, which is the graphics package I use on my Macintosh. And there are two versions of Pixelmator. There's the standard classic version and the slightly more expensive Pixelmator Pro, which is what I'm using today. But you will be able to do anything you see here on the classic version, or indeed apply the same principles to any graphic software. So we'll start off by creating an image in the standard YouTube thumbnail dimensions. And those are 1280 pixels by 720 pixels with a resolution of 300 dpi. However, in this case, I'm going to bump up the size slightly just to make it easier to see what's going on. So once we have our image set up, we can import a picture. And in this case, the image I'll be using is a screenshot I took using Sketch. So I'll drag in this picture of Gaudia, then use these picture handles to shrink her down to size. And the picture handles are these little white square dots. And there we go, and that's more or less how we want to frame the image. Now we've been doing all this using the Arrange tool, which is the first tool on the right hand menu, the little arrow icon. But now we want to go down the list to another tool called Quick Selection. And within Quick Selection, we want to pick Select Subject. So Select Subject is quite a clever tool, where the software identifies the main subject of a picture, then automatically draws an outline around it. So in this case, the software has identified Gaudia here as being the object of interest and has drawn an outline around her. Now the tool is not perfect and it's left out some areas. So there are some areas of hair that have been excluded and also this area of leg down the bottom. So to add these excluded areas to the main selection, we go to the Add tool. There's an Add tool and a Subtract tool. And the Add tool highlights areas of the image in orange. And to include one of these highlighted areas in the main selection, we just click on it. So we've added the area of leg. Now we want to try the same with the hair, highlighting and clicking to add the missing areas. And if we wanted to, we could do this in reverse by using the Subtract tool to remove areas that were added to the selection by mistake. So that appears to be done, so I'll now use the Zoom tool to bump up the magnification to 400%, and that will let us take a closer look. Okay, so everything seems to be in order, apart from a tiny area of hair that's still missing. So we go back to the Add tool and do our best to include it. So that's all done, and now the next step is to delete parts of the picture. If you look at the image handles, the little square dots, you can see they're gathered around Gaudia. And this shows us that she's been selected. But if we now right-click the image, we can choose Invert Selection, and this flips everything around. Everything except Gaudia has now been chosen. And you can tell that because the image handles are spread around the outside of the image. So at this point, I just delete the background by pressing Command X. And I also switch off the image layer to reveal this grey hatched area in the background. Next up, we change tools. This time we pick the Style tool and we turn on Stroke, then select the outline color from the palette, which we want as white. Then from this menu here, we want to choose Outside, and I'll explain more about this menu in a moment. And the other thing we do is change the outline width to 6 pixels. And as you can see, we now have a nice white highlight all around Gaudia, and the highlight extends out from the edge of her outline by 6 pixels. In contrast, if we'd selected Center as the option, the highlight would extend outside the outline by 3 pixels and inside by 3 pixels. And if we'd chosen the Inside option, then all 6 pixels would be inside the image, effectively eating into it, which we don't really want. Next up, we export this image as a PNG file, meaning that this grey hatched background will become transparent. And now I just press Command Z to undo all the changes we've done so far and get us back to the start. The next job is to find the PNG file I just exported and drag that into the list of layers on the left here. So you can see the PNG layer is at the bottom there, but if I drag it to the top, it takes precedence over the other layers. And et voila, Here's our lovely white outline again, looking very smart indeed. So we're almost done. At the moment, Pixelmator is treating this image as a series of individual layers. But if I want to combine them, I hold Shift to select them all. Then go to the top menu and select Arrange. And that joins everything together into a single image. And there we go, and that's about it. It's fairly straightforward. But I hope you found that useful and interesting. Hope to see you again soon. And until I do, I shall say goodbye. Okay then, cheerio.